What's up, everybody? It is the Black Knight, and as you can see, we've got a whole bunch of stuff going on here in this new part of the castle. Yes, I've been doing some building.
Better than ever.
Out here, you gotta take things one day at a time.
Settlers working out. Apparently, these are some of the things that. Let's walk out of here because we're given so much interruptions. Brought Piper along. Because we're going to do a little more building.
My ocular sensors are well suited for travel at night.
Yeah, we're not going
anywhere. Crop's been growing pretty good lately.
That's good. As you can see, we have been building up the defenses. This is an area I've made for myself called the General's Quarters, as you can see. And we'll take a look at that when it's not infested with robots, which happens. We're pretty well covered from all aspects of the Pridowin. They're gonna have to face an awful lot of rockets. Rockets. Plenty of rockets. Lots of red glare. And we got more rockets over here. We got some laser guns. Now I've added on this section here. You'll see we have some more guns here, more guns at the entrance. We have some guns over on this side, get lasers over here and over here. While we're up top, we'll take a look at the up top side here. Now this was originally going to be enclosed, and then I thought, yeah, for right now, we'll leave it open. I might just put a roof and then build up from it. Because there was a couple alignment issues. You know how it is, where you have a gap, and I just hate gaps in the... See how it's kind of a little off here? If I move this out, probably... It'd be something along those lines. I could probably straighten it out. I might still straighten it out. But we put in a nice little dorm here to increase the overall, the overall bed space here at the castle. So now we've got how many beds? 48 beds. And 20 people. So we're doing good there. This is apparently a new addition with one of the DLCs. I don't know if it's the Vault DLC, which is very more likely than the Raider DLC. So I'm putting Christmas trees wherever I can find them because that's cool. And you can see I got my standard flags, pictures, and giant claw kind of decorations, storage, just to make it nice for the people. Pretty well lit. Piper here is sporting ballistic weave enhanced stuff. That's why she's wearing a funny hat. She's got a lot of DR now. None of the clothes that I've been finding for when I find a set, maybe it's another set of military fatigues. I'd hate to put her back in military fatigues, that's outside, but I think the military fatigues still work much like this with the armor. So we'll get her up armored a little bit better. Although for what she's got right now, she should do well. Jump up here. We have to get someone manning that position. Maybe we'll build some more robots. I do want to build some more robots. Robots are going to be part of the overall defense. And I might want to build out here. Just build straight out into the sea. At a height. Not down on the ground, but at a height. Maybe add some more more water generation down there. You can't have too much water. So we have some plans here. There's just one other thing I was going to show you as far as my... Overall prepper. What the?
Whatever it is we're looking for, I'm certain we'll find it soon. My databanks are continuing to accumulate vast amounts of data regarding the Commonwealth.
You're gonna have vast amounts of data falling into the sea pretty soon. Are you guys having like a romantic moment? We don't have enough romantic moments, Piper.
Would you like me to go with you?
No, not even a little bit. Let's see, there's Preston. I don't think he's got
any. My back hurts, my feet hurt.
Preston!
Everything hurts.
Even when he's just standing there, he's annoyed. Alright. Now, this has been my main suit of armor, my coiled prism Tesla zap everything armor, and I'm very still fond of it, and I have it on display here. At least it was on display, it might be a little forward. Now it's on display here in the power armor display. That's supposed to turn lights on or something. But this is going to be my new exploration armor. Okay, so I'm at this. It's completely lead plated. It's all T60. And it's got a rocket pack, jetpack on it. I found out I could make the jetpack. I don't know what I did to do that to earn that, but we got there. So that's going to be my new exploration armor when we head into the glowing sea. Another thing, I think this might be Raider stuff. Now you have these display racks for heavy weapons and things. And we finally got the pegboards like you see in the trailer. They finally got that working. There, you know, Kellogg's pistol, you son of a bitch. Eddie's piece, significant righteous authority. That was really my main gun for a long time going in. Two-shot automatic radium rifle, that's very nice. The last minute, we got the never-ending hardened piercing submachine gun. That's always a good one over here. We got the Vault 81 Special, which I think I named that one. That's the Syringer. December's Child, which I forget what that does. Old Reliable, the Furious Machete, a Ghoul Slayer's Machete. He doesn't like machetes, you know? Plasma-infused automatic assault rifle, that's good. A Defiant hardened radium rifle. Never-ending hardened piercing 10mm. That was another mainstay weapon. That and my Righteous Authority were the ones that I used to use all the time. This is going to be, I'm kind of prepping this for, as you can see, when eventually we get Sean, in one form or another, gets to come back. He'll have toys and stuff to sleep with and basketballs. And it's just, you know, these are some, I think, vault things that they give vault statues I put in just for the heck of it. A little something to remember my wife by, you know. And so what we've got here is, what we're going to do is before we start building things, and I don't know if you're into building things with me here. I figured if I'm going to do it, I may as well let you watch. I did do a video without any voiceover on how do I build everything over there, but I'm not sure if I'm going to voice that over or not. Or if you guys want to see that, then I can upload it just as its own thing. But before you do a lot of this, because you can generate a lot of XP building, definitely sleep. We're going to sleep till morning. And you definitely want to sleep with one of your lovers around, because then you get the XP bonus from the lover's embrace, and then you can practically just level yourself like crazy whenever you build. You have to get up from the chair. Why wouldn't you... Well, I don't know. It'd be nice if they had some way of putting them in bed, which would be the way it's the whole lover's embrace thing. Now,
What a surprisingly pleasant day.
Perhaps she'll shut up. Decorations for new structures. I don't know why that's not showing up. Concrete. Let's try a concrete floor. Can we just build onto the castle? No. And I ran into this before, but there is a method. If you go concrete stairs. Now, concrete stairs, that'll work. You can hook that up there. And then get your concrete floor. That looks crooked. What the heck is it? That's not the floor we want.
9 a.m. here at Radio Freedom.
Okay. Throw one down just so you get something going. Let's see. How far out can we take this? As you can see, I can do 6,000 of these floor pieces. So if I don't get to put guns on it or anything, because I need more aluminum or radioactive material. Okay, so that's as far as we can go that way. You see, I'm getting 5 XP every time I lay something down here. And that's partially because of the bonus afforded by the lover's embrace. And yeah, poor Piper. She's been stuck in the slugs so long. She's fun to have around. So I don't know. I like Piper. You may have your own opinion about Piper. I just respect that. But I'm a fan. I like the pipes. Interesting fact that now we can actually build a little inward, too. I know it doesn't matter, but symbolically I don't want to block the angle on the guns. And again, I could build this right over the entire top of the castle, but the engineer in me says, you know, then it'll screw up the radio reception on the Freedom whatchamacallit network, and that's... Thank you. That doesn't mean we can't put a bridge across. A bridge might work. That might be nice. Let's see. Where do we want to take off from there? See, the nice thing about this is eventually when I have enough material, we could put guns on this, covering all over the place. We're coming in at an odd angle, though. We can definitely see that. Then we could. Grab some stairs in. Okay, now you can get from one side to the other. That's good. Anything teleports in here, it will get annihilated. Okay, can we put any guns down? As part of the guns really are a big deal. The defense on this. Turrets. 14 machine gun turrets. Heavy. How many heavy laser turrets? That's the ones we want. Let's put a. Let's set maybe about 5. Because that's how many we can do. We'll do alternating sides here. That doesn't do much for us unless. Can we? No? Nope. Okay, fine. We can get that. We can get there from here. Watch this. Connection. Let's get a big old power pylon. Might be even easier if we do it with the lower one. It's a regular teensy weensy one. And then run the wire down. Please don't fall. Hurrah! Huzzah! Guns up. And then just as a point of style, we're gonna put a big power pile on. Hanging just off like this. And another one. Just like this. So that we can go.
11 a.m. here at Radio Freedom.
Power that voice power pile on. Power that men. Power pile on. And all now people won't have to have their heads cut off by the wires. You know, it's. See, it works perfectly.
Nothing to report. Stay safe out there, everyone.
Back over here. Structures. We go back into concrete. They got a lot of concrete. A lot of potential here. That wasn't what we wanted. Store that floor. Store that floor in the ding dong. Okay, here we go. I wonder how we're doing on leveling up. Okay. We're outside the buildable area there. Good. At least we know. Lock this out here. You know, here, let's take a little break so it doesn't get too monotonous. Okay, I realize I've probably gone a little bit further than I should have with all of this, because it does eclipse this gun a little bit. If you go over here, you have to go like that. Oh, hey, look! Artillery, which will be an interesting thing on this side. I don't know, do we really want it extended out this far? Well, the nice thing here is I can mount a whole bunch of rocketry on this side. Just to, can we do any rockets? Would it be funny if we could put like a barn up here? You bit a barn? You just plop a barn right down right here. I'm not gonna plop a barn. No, we're not gonna do that. Get back in. Let us look at our defense turrets. Missile. You do 4 missile turrets, which is not as many as I'd hoped to have had for right now, but we could do that. Yeah, we'll have power out here before too long. The southern approach is a known approach for bad guys. And that's all well within the range of these guns, so that's nice. No, don't store the floor, we'll fall through. We need more oil. Yeah, we need more aluminum and more oil, mainly. A little more straying a little bit. Now, I haven't really properly thought of how I want to use this space yet. I'm thinking some more dormitories. I'm definitely thinking, though. Hey, wrong button. I want to back downward. That perhaps this could be like a nice dinner area out on the veranda for the people, so we can increase some happiness. So, you know, stores. Trader, you know, general. Wow, that's like, this is new. Would you look at that? Wow, I'm trading Emporium. Okay, let's bring it in a little bit. Drop a trader there. This could be so much more space efficient. See, that's a regular trader. Armor, weapons, food and drink. Can we get that with the food and drink? A regular kind of bar is there too. Oh, yo, this is good. It says bar. Oh yeah, this is, I'm happy with this. I'm happy with the style of it. It looks modern, it looks completely out of place with the rest of it. That's how we like to do things here, you know? Because, I mean, look, which would you rather have? Look, I got myself a lemonade stand, or a serious clinic going on here. Clothing? Oh, we can get you clothing. First time I've really tried to do a whole lot with, you know, happiness and things here at the castle. The castle's really been the, you can bump them right up against each other. That would be really, that'd be space saving. Kristen, you can't get in and out between them. I do want to do that though. Let's do that. Let's make it a constant wall of stuff. No, we're going to put it right up to the edge, but we are going to say, okay, we did trader. We'll do him an arm in order. We'll put armor, bump it. Weapons? Weapons, anyone? Leveled up? Haha. See, I told you. You got that whole food and drink right in the middle. Then you get your clinic. You need to get a dock going there. And a clothing store. And we just have enough room there to pull that off. Maybe we'll leave this all open. We have an open veranda kind of cool thing. We can do some cool stuff with it. Let's see. Can we get... I go put up a cat cage? But yeah, we'll put the cat cage out here on the edge. Still, because the place needs a cat, you know? But we have a dog cage. I don't remember them having a dog cage. Get a dog cage. We don't need mole rats. We don't need a mutant hound. This is more for, you know. And hopefully the Deathclaw, Mike Lurk, no. Yaogwai. No, we're not going to do any more of that. I wonder if the dog... You know, let's store the dog cage. I don't know if the dog is going to come out and just start eating people. The cat, you know you're safe. Raider flag? No, we don't need raider stuff here. That'll just annoy people. Power, we want to go with connectors and switches. That's just a connector we want. A small switched power pylon just to go just for the cat. Then we're gonna wire it right to that cat cage. We're gonna throw up a big pylon. It's a regular big pylon. Because we're gonna have guns over there. I mean, we're gonna have some stuff going on. We might put some lights up. You're gonna need periodic power pylons for lights. Nothing more can be built! You have no idea what my plans are. Do you guys want me to go over the method for fixing that? I might as well go over the methods for fixing that. En route for the method for fixing that, we'll take a walk down here. As you can see, we already have some things built here. Again, I don't know that I ever manned them. We got guns, we got more guns, and these are all in out in this direction, just in case anything teleports in. We got some new...
So much distance.
Yeah, no, you keep saying that. I'm thinking of moving you, Cotsworth. It's freaking out. Now, you wonder, why do we have all these guns here? These heavy lasers. Well, if you go down through here, you can get out. Which means that despite those couple of machine guns there, if you go back in through here, you can get in. And if you're not wanted here, it's not going to go well for you. So, if for some reason we have trouble on this side of things, we've got machine guns up here, machine guns here, machine guns here, machine guns here, and machine guns here. Machine gun there. We got missiles, machine guns, lasers, missiles, machine guns, lasers, yeah. This is where people come. You can see it's now the castle. And they better not go there if they're not friendly, because we like friendliness. See? More stuff. Still gonna try and bolster the defenses even more, because I really, when it comes time to defend the castle, I want the castle defended. Okay, now. I'm sure you guys may, some of you may have seen this before. We're gonna, for the uninitiated or people just watching this video, we're gonna do it again. This is the workshop where it normally is. I've put a storage cabinet here, into which I'm gonna put my really favorite weapons here. You know, we're just gonna, that we don't want to be lost for any Anodax and no reason. Now we're going to transfer from the workshop. I have some amount of weapons just in here. Just anything, but the bigger, more complicated stuff. Oh look, there's a flare gun, and I might have left these from before in the rain. So that works. So now, we go into here, we go to weapons, and we drop everything. You dump it all out. And you think, that looks really kind of goofy, why would you do that? Well, now you go into, you press V, you go into the build mode here. You can see the size is maxed out, nothing more can be built. Now watch that yellow bar as we store things in the workshop. Store the weapons in the workshop. That's what you want to do. As you can see, the bar is going down because it thinks I'm taking things out of the settlement. The actual built stuff suddenly thinks this stuff is He thinks I'm disassembling the settlement. So now, you completely tricked the thing out. This is the only way that I could have pulled off building as much as I already have.
This is Radio Freedom. All quiet here.
Now we're back into green already. And there you have it. Now, if I want to, let's say I know I'm going to build a lot more, which I know I'm going to build a lot more. You go back here, you go to the transfer. There are all the weapons I just picked up and put into the workshop. And again, I think the more polygons that the weapon has, the more effect it has. By the way, what we're cheating out the size limit here by a good... I forgot to drop. We're cheating out the size limit by making you think we're making things smaller when we're not. So therefore, if that was put in to say, oh, I don't know, protect your video card or keep lag from happening when there's so much stuff happening. Like, I don't know when all of these guns fire at once. Not sure how well the comp is going to take it. Though there are some, you're accepting some risk here is what I'm saying. We'll keep doing this. It's a rinse, lather, repeat kind of thing, you know? Enough for right now. I can go back and do it some more in a little while if need be, but the one thing you don't want to forget to do is get your stuff, you know. I'll leave the vertebrate grenades for right now.
Where should we go next?
And then back up top. Okay, so that's a problem. Let's see if you can fix that. Nope, maybe it's not a problem. Thank you, Piper. That was very useful. Okay, I've been thinking this over. And this is kind of the same layout I used for Spectacle Island, because the spectacle was over here on that, because that's where we had the cereal bowl. And it's a much smaller area. Maybe we want to have it the other way this time. Yeah, you'll see what I mean in a second. This up this way. Just moving stuff around over this way. Let's see, we'll try to leave a gap. And the reason I'm doing this is so that can have a view, the diners can have a view of the sea. And of course the power pylons, but the power pylons along with probably whatever guns I put on that side will end up being kind of the railing for safety. See, so now you can have this, you can go down from structures into furniture, over to tables, and let's find, where's our favorite dining out? Here we go. Do they have any new kind of patio table kind of things? Probably from the upgrade. All kinds of tables in this game. That's nice, it's beautiful, it's steel, it's very small. They don't have anything like the patio tables, which are what I love for outdoor dining. Usually do a mix of these and patio tables. We'll do some picnic benches. I don't want to get too close to the edges here. I don't want to get too far from the bar. And I like those simply because they are, you know, very efficient as far as seeding is concerned. And speaking of seeding, where is the most elegant? There we go. And not the steel ones. We're gonna go, there we are. Maybe we need to lay down a bunch of chairs here. Hopefully this will get some of the people out of my quarters. Because that's like the one place where there's a table. And everyone's like, look, a table! Oh my goodness, I love a table! Why am I stuck on a thing? Alright. Amazing, an hour went by just... Excuse me. I wonder, what do you think about that? What do you think about compressed time scales in games? It seems like it's the standard thing. It's always been that way with Fallout. You get a day in like four, you know, same thing with Grand Theft Auto. And just watch the sun fly across the sky as if you're on some sort of strange drug. Wandering in. Okay, well, that's nice. Now, there are a couple other things we need in this kind of public area here. It's, you know, besides more guns. Let's see. Let's go to furniture containers. Coolers. Coolers kind of make sense. You know, back here, maybe you can have a couple coolers. Maybe you're gonna get in the way. You can put a cooler up top. Can we do that? Can't seem to put them anywhere. I don't want to put it here. Like, it would look cool, it would make sense, but it might interfere with operations. Maybe we won't do that. But, where's our special things? Yeah, we don't necessarily need an iBot pod. But that would be good. Okay, we need more nuclear material. More for that, too. Where did we find... Is it resources? Miscellaneous? I guess I should throw a bell up here, right? Put a bell. Yeah, we can put a barber chair. Just for the heck of it. The surgery chair we should probably have behind the clinic. Should be right around there. Give the guy enough room to work. A pillory. I don't know if that works. That's research. Where are the... You know, that stuff. I'm looking for that, that device that takes away radiation. Is that a crafting device? The heck... The Nuka Mixer Station? It's getting dark out there, people. Stay safe. Nothing to report at the moment. Stay tuned for updates. What? How can we not? really. Nuka Mixer, wow. Mix your own Nuka Cola, I guess. Well, here you have it, folks. Now we are the first settlement, and we have an unlimited supply of Nuka Cola. That probably requires some kind of... Oh, quitting time siren. Yeah, we should have that. For the heck of it. To call everybody. It's like the bell. Under crafting. Oh, where's like bizarre stuff here? You know, it's your power? Miscellaneous?
7 p.m. here at Radio Freedom. Nothing to report. Keep it tuned here for Minutemen Orders.
There it is. That's another thing you really need. And we'll zip this over a little bit closer to the power so we can. You definitely need that. Now I'm really low on aluminum. You know, I've never even figured out what that's supposed to do. In game. The Nixie Cube. Can we lay it down? We can lay it down. Run some power out here. We're right to that switch. Now, obviously, you have to feed some power over here. We got some close power. Let's run it from here. And another big one here. It over that way.
You're tuned to Radio Freedom. Nothing to report. Keep it tuned here for Minutemen Orders.
Okay, that's enough. Probably more than enough. And yes, I am obsessive enough that you wouldn't want all the power running through all of the, Now. We're getting close to the watch the magic happen moment. And there it is. Guns are up. And everything else here is powered. Can we assign that Minuteman?
You're listening to Radio Freedom, the voice of the Minuteman. All quiet across the Commonwealth.
And let's get the bar up.
Got it.
The resource is now assigned. I heard that doesn't work very well. They'll just stand around and not do anything because they're Minuteman. But if it's assigned, that might just trick everything out. What if we activate? That's powered off. Okay, so we need to power it up.
My systems are continuing to function at peak efficiency.
So now we'll see if we ever get a cat.
Another day of hard work. never changes.
All right, hey, the bar is working. The bar is open. Now we need some lights. Yeah, we need guns too, but we need lights. Some lights I can make. And they have some cool ones now. Some street lights.
All quiet here.
Fluorescent lights. Those are all ceiling lights. Then we'll go with the street lights. Which ones do we like? Kind of like the more kind of French kind of thing going here, you know. Yeah, rotate it this way. And get some lights for these guys. Leaves may need to be directly wired. I thought they could just glow off of the fact that there were power pylons around. I haven't done it in a while.
This is Radio Freedom, broadcasting all day, all across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report. Keep it tuned here for updates.
Alright, let's see. Do we need to wire the street lamps? Yes, we do. Alright. And let there be light. Let's keep wiring them all up. Okay, I've wired these up. And that goes to there, and that goes to there. Is it too many points off of one thing? And why aren't these cross connections working? It's like they each want their own power connection? What the... That's not how that works. I don't know. Let's just do this. Let's just throw another one down here. Gotta have light. Okay, now that's all.
Remind them what it's all about.
This is pretty reminding what it's all about, dude. Look at this. I mean, you have a view of the ocean.
Wouldn't you say?
That might be, Spectacle Island over
what
there.
We're fighting for.
Where is he?
Yeah?
I must apologize for the odd noises I currently emit.
Is there something you need?
Just want to trade.
I want to trade a few things.
Sure thing.
See, did we ever... He's got his... No, he's not running... He's got his colonial duster on, but he's not... Or maybe that's not what he's wearing. Let's see, what if we... Let's change that temporarily. To a Minuteman outfit. And then put all this stuff back in. No, I don't want to take it. We want to just, you know, re-equip it. I have to get him... I'm just making a note that I have to get him some, whatchamacallit.
Anything else?
Nope, that's it.
No.
Okay. Was well built for travel. You know. These modifications will be adequate for quite some time. You know. Okay, so you're wondering what the heck happened here. Well, after what you just saw, I proceeded to explain that I was just trying to see if Preston had any ballistics armor on him. He doesn't. And I finished up a couple things. I got the lighting right. I did this. And I went to go place a fireworks launcher, a firework mortar. At which point the game froze. And it corrupted the last 8 gig of Fraps video I was taking, so that you can't see those things that happened after that. And then Windows 10 declared an unrecoverable error and rebooted the system. None of this was saved. None of it. It's all gone. It's gone. It's gone, I tell you! Alright. So, normally you'd say, ah, Bethesda, this, that, and the other thing, but I am circumventing the overall size of the settlements by doing that stupid trick with the guns, which I'm going to continue to do. I guess you have to know that sometime this will happen. And I think that's a wonderful place to end this video while I rebuild everything so it looks roughly like it did before. And I don't think you need to see that. You don't want to watch it twice, do you? Why would you? Why would you want that? So on that note, looking at the blank expanse that was my beautiful bistro area, this is the Black Knight and Piper. Have a great night.
If it's not one thing, it's another. Well, gotta run.